This is how to put text behind any object in Premiere Pro. First method you can use is really good when you have a bright sky like this. So duplicate your window layer by holding Alt and dragging it above your text layer. Now go to the effects panel and search color key and apply the effect to the top window layer. Now go to the effects controls and click on the dropper tool next to key color. Now go to the preview window and hold Control while clicking on the sky to select a wider color range. Now play around with the color tolerance until your text is visible. But as you can see, this might not be the best method, but there are still two methods left that we can use. Now the second method works really good if you have a dark background like this. So start off by selecting the text layer, then in effects controls expand text. Now under appearance click on fill and simply change the color to red, green or blue. And I can tell you why this is important in a second. Back in effects controls, scroll down to the opacity tab. Next to blend mode, click on the drop down menu and then try all different blending modes until you see that the text is behind the objects. Typically darken, multiply and linear burning work really good in this case. That's also the reason why we chose red, green and blue, because if you switch to white you can see that it doesn't work. Now the third and last method works in every clip. So start to duplicate your window layer by holding Alt and dragging it above your text layer. With the top layer selected, go to effects controls and click on the three dot bezier. We are now gonna make a mask around the object, so it might be better to zoom into the preview window. Now make a precise outline of the object you want to have in front of your text, and make sure to connect the last dot with the first dot in order to create a complete mask. We have now created a mask with the object in front of our text, but if you scrub through the timeline you can see that the camera is moving and the text looks really weird, and that's because we haven't tracked the mask. Now select the top window layer, keyframe mask path and make sure that you're at the start of the clip, then click on the play button to track the mask. Now as you can see it looks way better now, and we can still make changes to the text and it will still be behind the object. Now if you find this video helpful then please subscribe and I'll see you in the next video.